Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to a vlog. It's been a while since our last one. Life's been slower, for sure. I've been trying to balance my to-do list, all these mundane, tedious tasks around the house, while also figuring out some things with my mental health and some things with my physical health. So I figured since we have a trip coming up that it would be a great chance to catch up, hang out a bit, and pack together.
Thank you.
Another day, another cafe. I had some other appointments to get to from the other day's footage you guys just saw. We still aren't done packing. We still gotta pack together. Basically, what I had to do was wait for the laundry. We had one more load, and of course, everything we needed was in that one load, of course. So I gotta fold that today, finish up our packing. Part of me really debated on buying some new packing cubes. I really want... Well, hello there. Christopher just got home. I really want to get the beige packing cubes, but was it worth the money right now? Plus, my color sold out? No. So, though it's not aesthetic, it's reality. And that's the vibes. I'm going to be using our old packing cubes. We're going to get into some things together. I'm in mid-filming of a reel right now. Christopher just brought lunch home. So, here we go, guys.
For lunch today, I got just some custom shrimp summer rolls from a place called Roleplay, but R-O-L-L, get that right. We're gonna eat a little bit of this.
And today, my morning computer station was here. Sometimes it's on the couch, sometimes it's in the office. It roams when I'm with my laptop. Desktop's obviously at a desk. I got my coffee. I also have a water bottle, so I was kind of dual fisting, dual handing today. We had someone come out to quote some lawn care, so that's what I've been handling, phone calls with that, emails. Something we have to do today is take a horizontal photo for my management company because they're redoing their website, and I don't usually take a lot of horizontal photos because Instagram, TikTok, all the above is more like a vertical profile. So my hair is kind of done, kind of. I did a little something to it, and then it's kind of doing its own thing today, to be honest, but it's fine. Put a little brow gel on, and we'll probably put a light bead on later because I obviously want to put a little light bead at least for the photo. We are just about to have lunch together. Christopher's having leftover pizza. Did I say hello, Christopher?
Hello.
There he is. He hasn't slept yet. He worked last night, went to go get a haircut, just got home, so we're gonna eat lunch and he's probably gonna sleep. At least you're off tonight.
Yes.
That's exciting. We are heading to Denver, but I haven't told you guys why. So Christopher's birthday's on Sunday. Are we excited?
Yes.
That's a lie. I think he's excited for the trip. I don't think he's excited for his birthday.
That's what I thought you were referencing.
Yeah, he's at the sink right now, like trying to wash his hands. He's turning 30. Both of us are turning 30 this year. So dirty 30, woo. Just ironically fell into the timeline of which we were gonna go to Denver. So it just happened to be a birthday trip that we're flying out on his birthday and snowboarding. So you'll see me packing the gear. The gear is the easy part, to be honest. We'll talk a little bit there. And then the clothes are pretty easy too, because I was asking Chris last night, are we really gonna go out to eat? Like the group that we are going, are we really going out to eat very often? Or are we ordering in to the Airbnb? And we're likely ordering in 75% of the time, probably. So I don't really need that much clothes, and I can kind of use most of my leggings that I wear for snowboarding, kind of just parts of my outfit. So I think we're gonna do carry-on and two gear bags. We're flying Southwest, so each of us get two bags free. We always like to fly Southwest with our boards and stuff just because it just makes it really, really easy. And if it's just me and him, then we really compact things down, but there's really no reason to. There's just a bunch of space in the car we rented now, so probably do a carry-on. If we can't fully fit in the carry-on, then we'll think about moving to the big suitcase and blending that with the gear bag. But yeah, that's the table of contents for today. I feel like this angle is so my space, and I don't know what to do with it right now, but I'm going to get into eating said lunch and check back in with you guys. Our gear bag for our boards, or our board bag, is in the garage. This is a Daikin tour bag. It fits both of our boards. Eventually, I think we're gonna get one with like wheels or something, but we don't travel enough with our boards to really need that. Excuse this. This is on my to-do list. I need to drop some clothes off to donate at our local neighborhood school. So there she is. I'm sure you guys have seen this before. If you follow me on Instagram, this is my board. She's my first board, my only board. I haven't got a second set up. Again, we don't go enough, but it's funny. When I first got her, I was, you know, still in my extreme Marvel phase, which I still love Marvel. So a lot of everything was kind of based off of black and white. This was one of the few boards that I liked in the size that I needed. I'm also gonna be very careful with how I'm holding these things because I do not want a fiberglass splinter because those suck. Usually, honestly, I would be wearing my gloves right now. right now. So if you see me in gloves, just let's pretend that you didn't. We are gonna put both boards in. This is my board, Christopher's board. It's a lot bigger. It's like the full length of the bag, and that's the only part that gets kind of tough. It's Christopher's Capita effing awesome board. His one usually gets a lot of spinners, so put it in better now. We're gonna put both boards in. We also need to put in my boots, which are the smaller boots. Chris's will go in a separate bag. We both rock some Nike boots. Those are mine. And then our pants. So let's see if I can get this in.
These are so sad because they're so like ripped up, but these are my $40, maybe even $30 gloves I got at Dick's Sporting Goods from the Spider brand when I first learned 4 seasons ago. And they've lasted really long. They're still pretty waterproof, but I mean, you can see they're kind of compromised. So I finally got new gloves this season. But I mean, the $30, $40 ones really went a far away. So I'm gonna wear these just to not get any splinters. Yeah, I'm a little bish. It is what it is. Have you ever had a fiberglass splinter and enjoyed it?
Quite heavy, but it will do. Gear bag, check.
We never filled out this little card thing, and honestly, it's kind of already beaten up and bruised, but in true cargo fashion, I'm just gonna put a quick little label from the label maker on there so I don't have to get anxious about the handwriting being great. I'm just gonna put C and S Robinson, and then I'll do one with like a contact number. Contact number and city and state, which of course you guys don't get to see because that'll be a little too much. While I'm doing this, if you've been boarding or if you traveled with your boards, I know it's different for everyone. We've never had an issue with like putting my boots in the bag. Most airlines allow you to put like a helmet, boots, and pants for one person in each bag. So we put our boards together, which we've never had an issue while we've flown United, Frontier, and Southwest with our boards. Never had an issue. But I do know some people, depending on where you're flying, if you're flying internationally, that they will check your bag. And if there's more than one pair of pants, one boot, and one board, then they make you take it out or keep it separately. So for those who are trying to use my video as a kind of an informative thing, it's not always the same. You know, it depends on the day and depends on who you're flying with and where. But we've never had an issue going to Denver. I'm just gonna leave it like that. It's better than it was, at least. If for some reason they tell me that I take out one of the pairs of pants, which I really doubt they will, then I will do that. But honestly, it saves them so much more trouble than having the board separately. So I don't think they ever care. It's never like too heavy, because I know there's like a weight limit. And I think it's about weight, and because ours is not overweight together, then no problem, right? So in my mind, my attention span sucks lately. It's just all over the place. It used to be really laser focused. Now I'm just, who am I right now? I'm trying to focus on what would make most sense to do next to relieve more anxiety from me. I think that would be doing our next gear bag before hopping over to another task like folding clothes and stuff like that. Now into our little gear bag. This is something we take with us to all of our local trips. We've never flown with it because usually we just take whatever's in here and put it into the big black suitcase. But I think we're gonna do this and a carry-on. Hopefully this time that's just the vibe we're going for. We have both our helmets in here, and usually I took a bunch of stuff in my helmet. We don't need our extra goggles, but maybe we'll take them just in case. We'll really see. Because typically we like to wear our full helmets, obviously for safety, and their full face helmets. They're both by Rubrock. We've been wearing them for a while. It was great during pandemic times because you also had like this extra layer of face protection. I really like mine because I've added in from a separate brand speakers into the side. So I can pull one out for you guys. They have these little red things in the ear area. It's like surround sound, and I have a remote control wired to the front of my helmet so I can turn up the volume, change the songs, and stuff like that with my helmet still on, which is nice. Chris has the Loki version, which is like a special one. And those both basically take up the whole top compartment of the bag with whatever I want to stuff inside of it. This time probably, I don't know. I usually take a beanie, take the, it's just like, one of the neighbors down the street is having something done to their house, and you know, typically like that company will walk around and ring everyone else's doorbell, so that just happened. But yeah, just in case for anxiety, and sometimes you just need things that you didn't think you'd need. I just put all of our stuff kind of in the helmet. So scarves will go in one, gloves will go in the other. I feel like I keep losing my train of thought, but anyway.
And at the very bottom of the bag, you can fit a pair of boots. Chris's boots are a lot larger than mine size-wise, so those fit better here versus going to the board bag where mine are. Which suitcase do we want to use? See the couch, especially the seat, all like crazy. Yuna loves sitting there. That's her favorite spot. So, this is an Instagram, it's real life. This is my main carry-on. I have a couple carry-ons that I've collected out through the years. Because it's blue on the inside, usually I'll use our blue packing cubes. That's what I was mentioning to you guys earlier, is that I was like, I've been wanting like beige packing cubes as well as like the Beis brand, B-E-I-S. Like I could have like their wallet and stuff like that. I love like the beige and the black in their line. They have suitcases. Those are on like my wants and will haves one day list, but it's not really needed for this trip. Is it a necessity? No, it's just the want. So I'm gonna be using what we have. So I have two packs from Amazon. These are Shaq packs, but they also have beige ones on Amazon, of course. Way more affordable actually than the designer brand ones. So I'll have some of those on my Amazon page. If you haven't started using packing cubes, I don't know how you enjoy packing because these make life so much easier. I feel like everyone uses them now. They come in a bunch of different sizes. So when we go on trips, like the parents will have one colors like this, and then the kids will have their own colors. But I think eventually whenever I do decide to get like a set of black and a set of beige ones, black will be Chris's, beige will be mine, and then like blue will be Ava's, and Mia will have red. So they'll be used regardless.
Welcome to my POV. This is one of my velvet lined leggings. I get them at Target. I really like them. These are from the Wander brand. They're amazing. They're called Hot Toddies. I wear them every cold season. I wear them for snowboarding and I wear them generally because they make you look good. They snatch you in and they are very comfy. But the thing is, they get really peely, as you can see, but easily fixed with a fabric shaver. So if you guys don't have a fabric shaver, I highly recommend it. Let's do a little before and after together. My fabric shaver is by Conair and it's on my Amazon, really affordable. You can just empty the little tray right here and continue using it. I've had it for a while. Let's do one side. It's really easy to do, truly. Like, it gets rid of all these little bowls. And the before and after is so serious. Like, it's nice and smooth on this side again. Like, none of this. You can just see, it just looks great, no damage, takes a few seconds, everything gets trapped in this little compartment right here that you just open and clean. In real time, watch that whole section. Voila. Nice and smooth again. I haven't had any issues of this damaging the fabric at all either, so highly recommend.
So something essential that we cannot forget, which I meant to put in the gear bag, is our jackets. We're both packing our lighter weight jackets because it is, you know, leaning into spring ski riding weather. So we're gonna use our dope snow jackets, which are just kind of like a waterproof layer, but nice and long.
Quickly look at my toiletry bag. This is my well-loved, well-used Bare Minerals bag. So this has three compartments. As you can see, it has a little hangy thing. This pouch, I usually keep some hair products in. So for quick trips, I don't need to bring a lot of hair products. So I usually use just some of the samples that you get when you purchase things. So this will be Chris's shampoo and conditioner for the trip since he has, you know, short hair. It's plenty. And if I do need to wash my hair, I could totally use it. That's why I also have a hydration hair mask in the bag at all times, just in case for my hair. But I usually wash my hair the night before we go, and it's good for the whole trip since we're only going a few nights and I wash once a week. So, but emergency, if I, you know, really need to, got really sweaty or something, they're right here. There's a few, you know, random cotton pads that hang out in the bag. This pouch always stays This pouch stays stocked with a nail file, some nail clippers, we have hair ties, tweezers, and band-aids, because you never know, there's even a cough drop just in case your throat's feeling a little dry. So I keep those things in there at all times. So that's kind of the emergency hair tie portion of things. Otherwise, I add in a clip. So we're gonna do this and this for our sleep scrunchie. This trip, we'll do these two, and we will tuck them, I think I'll tuck them in this section actually, just to keep it nice and contained. All right, next up is my shower cap. This always stays in my bag, but I just took out anything that was expiring, so they're just sitting next to me right now. But this is my spare shower cap. I have one that I wear at home all the time. This is from Lange, L-A-N-G-E. They're at Ulta now. It's microfiber inside, waterproof outside. It's a little tight on my big old head, but the one that I usually use at home that's looser is a different brand that's discontinued. So this is all I could get for the travel bag. Toothbrushes are something I add, obviously, day of, because we need our toothbrushes. I sometimes keep travel toothbrushes in here, but that's not what I plan on doing on this trip, so we're just gonna bypass that and I leave it unchecked so I don't forget. Toothpaste, got our mini toothpaste, slide her right on in, there we go. Hairbrush, small one will do for the trip, and then I'll add Chris's brush the day of as well, because it's just a little bulkier. Maybe we'll just tuck her in right there. If I was doing more and blow drying, then that'd be a whole situation, but different. So skincare wise, it varies. Sometimes I keep a set in my bag, and depending on the season, it's different. So my summertime one, I have some Onyx and Rose skincare in there, but she's not coming this time. And I have this like aloe moisturizer for summer sunburn issues. The cleanser for this trip will be the Glow Recipe Blueberry Gentle Cleanser. This is one of the little travel sizes, perfect for the bag, so cute. This is something I can leave in the bag. For mountain trips, I really need the hydration, so I'll bring a couple different hydrating products, this one being like my go-to. I usually keep this in the bag too for all winter trips. It's kind of on its last leg, so I might have to bring the full size, unfortunately. But let's pretend that it's not on its last leg. This is usually where it goes, and I'll tuck in the full size later, probably one of these slots. I'll bring some vitamin C, just as my morning. Sometimes, you know, I'll let it go for a few days, but I'll bring some vitamin C. This is my smallest one, so I'll be bringing the Ordinary's vitamin C. I do that in the mornings. And then, of course, it's very important, I bring sunscreen. So I'll bring a full size for first application, my favorite sunscreen. And then I'll pack a couple of these little sample ones from Kula. This one's a little bit more matte, but great for reapplication. So I'll keep a couple of these in my jacket when we go to the mountains so we don't get burned, because you're so high up and that's the only place my nose ever gets burnt. It's on the mountain. Let's slide that in right next to toothpaste for now. Things will get kind of, you know, rearranged, but that's typically what I try to aim to do, is put most things into the slots. Cleanser, serum, treatment, moisturizer. I'll also add like some sort of nighttime treatment, possibly, depending on what I'm feeling that week I need. But I try to get it all done beforehand so I can just have some normal moisturizer days. The summer Fridays will be our main moisturizer. Depending on the week, if my skin needs a treatment, I'll add something. I sometimes keep this in the bag and I might refill it with something else, which is the IT Cosmetics Nighttime Beauty Sleep Moisturizer, which is great. It has like AJs in it, so sometimes this will be just enough. So we'll have her in there. She matches the bag as well. Lip balm, some sort of lip balm, any lip balm. I don't have one that I have in mind yet, but a lip balm. I've been running out since it's been winter. My lips are so dry, but then I'll have this in my bag at all times. So I use a Native deodorant all the time. This is my second favorite scent. This is the lychee goji berry. I have the water lily purple one for daily use in my office. So this stays in the bag, kind of matches everything as well. Some extras that I forgot on the list, but I usually have in there. We have some hygienic wipes. Sometimes I'll add body wipes from the same brand, which is Good Wipes as well. So then when you put in our toothbrushes and Chris's hairbrush and his deodorant, that pretty much fills up the entire bag. So we typically see if there's body wash at the place, but we have a little mini body wash there as well. This is his cologne scent, so that's there. Sometimes he wants me to pack a travel loofah, so I'll add a new one in there sometimes. And that's really it for this bag. It's not too exciting. For lotion, I'll bring a small lotion of some sort. I have like a CBD hand cream. She'll fit, so she'll go this time. But if it's like a beach trip, I bring a full size bottle. And then this is not whey, but I refill this with my Target body oil, which I love a lot more. And this is a formerly body oil bottle from Wet. So I refilled it just half. I don't need too much. It's what body oil I use daily after the shower. It's the sesame scented one from Target Up and Up brand. But that's kind of what it looks like in here. So imagine just another hairbrush, toothbrushes on top, and then the deodorant probably slides in somewhere. And that will do. So a few bag substitutions. This is my CalPak book bag. A big fan of it. It's really nice puffer type of material, really durable, and I've traveled with it a couple times. If we need a backpack, Chris sometimes likes to wear one for any electronics he's carrying, then this would be what carries all of our electronics. I also have the matching cosmetic bag. So this is gonna be the hub for all our health items and opt in as our health bag for this trip. And this is my CalPak fanny pack. I have a lot of CalPak. My carry-on's also CalPak. This is something that I wear across my chest in the airport a lot, or we'll wear it on our backs while we're boarding because it's so lightweight and we can put like water bottles in it so we don't have to stop for water a bunch of times. This will definitely be in the trip, whether it be in my book bag or not. I'll absolutely be having a pair of my headphones. These are my noise cancellation ones. They're the Jabra 85s. I got them during the reno. They have little controls on the ear spot. Battery life is crazy good. Color super cute. Of course, you know I love my beige. It's sold out a lot, but if I can find it, I'll link it off for you guys. Really comfortable on and just gonna be bomb because they fold and they'll fit perfectly fine in the fanny. This bag is something I travel with a lot, so it actually has an eye mask in it for if I need it. But let's quickly pack our health bag together. So my pill box is something that I keep on me basically at all times. This is on my nightstand. I have a version of it in my car. It's a shame, but a girl has needs. So this is my spironolactone. It's what I take for my hormonal acne. I've done videos on it. A lot of people ask for updates. That's my 50 milligram. That's my 100 milligram. This is my daily once a day. And this is my add-on. So I'll take one of each on the weeks that I'm on my period or ovulating for extra hormone control. I have Claritin because it's allergy season now. I have Dramamine homeopathic medication. It actually works really well. It's like ginger based or something like that because I get car sick. So motion sickness, I need it. Excedrin for if I have any leg pain. Aleve for if I have any cramps. Levothyroxine, which is my thyroid medication that I have to take daily. I have Imodium because I get travel stomach. Your girl's stomach gets real upset with her anxiety. So just in case she needs a little control there, that is. And there's like some like Zyrtex and stuff there. So love this pill box. You can get it at Container Store or on Amazon. I'll link it off. So that will fluctuate between bags depending on where I am and where I'm going during the trip, but we'll put it in the health bag for now. Next up are my gummies. So I have to take vitamin D daily. This is from VitaFusion strawberry flavored gummies. They're really delicious. So I'm gonna have 4 days worth of these because my vitamin D be low. And then I will have a couple of these Wegman brand melatonin gummies, also strawberry. They're actually very good because sometimes I need melatonin when I'm sleeping in an unfamiliar place. It just helps me, especially the first night. The other nights, I really don't think I'll need it much, honestly, because I'll be so tired just from riding and whatever. But the first night, I feel like my anxiety is at all time high. So yeah. And I put it all into this little jar. This is my Onyx and Rose Bright Side CBD pills because she's an anxiety girl. And these are zero THC, so I have no problem flying because airplanes and airports are like federal territory. So sometimes there's rules about things, but because I only take oils that are zero THC or the pills, should be fine. I only take the pills when I really have to. Sometimes I get worried about the oil leaking or something like that, but I have them. They are 25 milligrams each. It keeps my anxiety down and my symptoms and my mind that races, all that good stuff. It helps me function. So I do have a promo code. It's kind of in fluctuation right now. I don't know if it's active. If it is, by the time this video goes on, I will have it in the info box for you guys. But as you can see, there's my vitamin D and my melatonin. And then you can see these are the CBD ones. So they're just like little gel pills. So I have that as kind of that easy on the go, no spill situation. But I also plan on taking my Onyx and Rose oil. I take their Pure Bloom. This is mint. My favorite flavors are sugar cookie, chocolate, coconut, and then to the mint because the mint is super strong. And this is actually the higher formulation. If you guys can see that, it's 2000 milligrams. So I'm almost out. I'll take it with me just in case I need it. I won't be heartbroken if for some reason it gets taken. It shouldn't though, because it is 0% THC, but we'll see. I usually do take this in the morning, just daily. Last but not least would be my liquid IVs. Must have for when I travel. I don't want to be on a plane without this, and I don't want to be on a mountain without this. And I drink one every single day, so it's kind of needed. I'm bringing enough for the crew, just in case, because they drink it sometimes as well. So this is my liquid IV in passion fruit, my favorite flavor. I've tried all the flavors in the brand, so if you aren't following me on Instagram, I have a highlights of when I try all the stuff, and I kind of keep everything ranked for you guys. This is my favorite. She's Queen Bee, and then second in command, the Chelsea to our Raven, this is Golden Cherry. She is amazing, tasty, a newer girl, but I love both of these. These are my top two, and then Guava is my third. If you like Sour Patch Kids, you would really like these flavors because they have that like sour sweet situation. But Guava's more mellow for those who want something more mellow, and I think it goes well with anything. So these help me a lot to prevent cramping on the mountain, like a runner's cramp from just working out. Also helps me rehydrate after the plane dehydrates me, and it also helps me tolerate already drinking a lot of water because I really don't like a lot of water. Helps with migraines. It helps with everything. It basically takes, in their opinion, one bottle of water and makes it the effects of three bottles of water, which is kind of awesome. So if you haven't tried them, it's not sponsored. I am an affiliate. I'll give you guys my code just in case you want to save coins. It's actually cheaper than buying from Costco if you use my code and you get the big pack. So there she is. Enjoy that if you would like it. But yeah, that's the primary person in this bag, because I don't joke. One time we went to Colorado without it and I caught a horrible cramp that lasted hours and it was painful to ride that way. So not doing that again. My feet cramp sometimes when we ride, so we'll zip her up and thank her for helping us survive.
Okay guys, we are all done. Thank you guys for joining me. I am out of breath. Dream liquid IV loaded. Whew. Get myself together. It's been a long day, but all the bags are packed. Everything is in. We're zipped up, ready to go. Nice and organized and efficient, hopefully. I have a few days to kind of pick my brain to make sure we haven't forgotten anything. I typically forget one thing every trip. We'll see what it is this time. It's gonna be a very interesting trip. I realize I never told you guys. The kids aren't coming, if it wasn't apparent, just through the packing. So basically, we're going on the days that they're with their dad, and then we'll be back on the day that we actually have the kids. They have school as well, because we're going weekdays. So it just won't work out, and we still gotta get them into the mountain life. They're not into it yet. They really aren't. But I wish we could take them. I really want to take them to Denver one day. So fingers crossed that happens. That will definitely have to be like a winter break thing, because you know, school. Like, parents, I know you're riding with me. School. You can't really plan trips around that. Plus a co-parenting custody schedule. Ugh. Forget it. It's a lot of work. Summertime's way easier to do things. Anywho, I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope this kind of gives a little something to those who really miss the vlog videos. I see the messages across all my social networks and I feel for you guys. Vlogs just aren't something that, one, I have really like a huge passion to film. Like, this was fun because I have something to do, like we're packing. But if day to day, I don't do none, guys. I just live on my couch. Let's be honest. I do nothing. Nothing. And that's been the case for the last 2 years, especially more so than before. And I'm also just not as set up for vlogs. There's a lot of angles, a lot of batteries used, a lot of tripods, lighting is in question, you know. So aside from a lot of editing, it's just more of a process than my beauty videos, which I'm always set up for in my office. So that's a main reason why I don't vlog as much anymore. If something exciting happens and I feel passionate enough to do so, then I can commit to something like this. So I hope it was fun to watch. I like watching these back. That's like the best part about it. It's just a lot of work. So I still need to go do a few things, like donate the clothes and take the pictures for my management company, because that just didn't end up the case before the sunset today. And I also have to go visit my sister, my mom, and my nephew. So I'm gonna go do that. And I'm gonna leave you guys off with my recent uploads, my subscribe button. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate you guys. Stay hydrated. I'll see you guys later.